In this video, we will show you how to create and update a Supabase record from a WeWeb interface. Okay, so in WeWeb, I have installed the Supabase data source plugin, and I have a collection that gets a selected car. So this is the car that I have here. And I've also added the Supabase authentication plugin, and I am currently logged in as a user. So what I want to do is book this car. I want to reserve this car. So on this button here, I will create a workflow to create a booking. And here, because I have the Supabase data source plugin, I have access to these no-code actions to select, insert, update, upsert, or delete a record. So in Supabase language, select is getting data, reading it. Insert is to create a new record. Update is to update a record. Upsert is to update a record if it exists, or create a new one if it doesn't yet exist. And delete is to delete a record. So here we want to insert a new booking. And we want to create a record in the bookings table that we have here in Supabase. So we have an ID that will be created automatically by Supabase. We have a timestamp that will be have the default value of now. Then we will need to tell Supabase to give Supabase the user ID of the user who is making the booking, and also the car ID of the car they are booking. And then we can also send a start date. So in WeWeb here, I can select which fields I want to update. So I don't need to send any data for the ID or for the created at columns. I need to send data about the user ID, the car ID, and the start date. So here I will map to the user who is authenticated here. The car ID I can find in my car collection, which only has one item, which is the car that I selected. And the start date I will map to the date and time picker that I have on my page. So now if I test this, it will fail. There we go. We get an error saying that the new row violates row level security policy for the table bookings. This is because in Supabase, we have enabled row level security on our bookings table, and this is a good thing, but we have not yet created policies. So it's important to enable row level security on your tables at Supabase, because if you don't, it means that everybody can read or update or delete your data. So you want to enable row level security. But once you've enabled row level security, you also need to create policies, security policies that tell Supabase what people can and cannot do with this table. Otherwise, you won't be able to do anything and you'll get error messages like we got here. So the first thing we want to do is enable read access to everyone, so everyone can work on this this bookings table in the public schema. We could change this. We could decide that it's only authenticated users. For simplicity's sake, for now, we'll just use the template and enable everyone to read the bookings. If we wanted to allow only authenticated users, we could say authenticated here, and then only authenticated users could see the record. Another option would be to say that users can only see their own records, which is something we will do later. So now let's save this policy. And the second policy we want to create is we want to allow people to insert a new record, so to create a new record. And we want only authenticated users to be able to do this. So we will use a template. It's for inserts. The user needs to be authenticated and it needs to be true. So now that we have these two policies, if we go back to WeWeb and test again, it will be a success. A new record will have been created in the bookings table. And if I go back to my bookings here, I just see the new record here. So ID 19, which is this ID here. Now, one thing that's very important to understand is that when you send data to Supabase, your table expects a certain format. So here it expects a UID, which is a string, a text, and here it expects a timestamp. If we change this and instead of sending a timestamp, for example, we tried to send blah blah 35, we would get an error saying the input syntax is incorrect. So we are not sending a timestamp. And since we're not sending a timestamp, but Supabase wants a timestamp, then Supabase returns an error. Okay, now we did this a bit quickly. The policy, let's go back to our policies in Supabase and make sure that users can only read their own bookings, because we don't want users to be able to see other users' bookings. So let's try a new policy. And here we will say, let's start with a template. Okay, so this looks pretty good because it's checking the user's ID. So we will use this template. So this here is checking that the ID of the authenticated user matches the user ID of the booking. And we'll change this delete to a select and update this to enable select based on user ID. Let's save this and let's just make sure that in our table we have user underscore ID. So I will save this policy, go back to my table, and yes, it's called user underscore ID. So it will be able to work. That condition will work. And I will just go back to my policies and remove the read access for all users. Now people can only see the bookings that are related to their own user ID, and they can only create a new record if they are authenticated. Let's try again. Let's go back to my workflow and let's try this again. There we go. So again, we managed to create a new record. But the good thing is that now if I create a collection for the bookings in WeWeb, I am only able to see four bookings, the four bookings that I made with as this user, DC27, DC27, DC27. Okay, now let's say that instead of creating a record, I want to be able to update a record. So I would look for the update action and the booking. I would need to say which booking I want to update. So for example, I could get booking number 6, and then I would say I don't want to update when it was created or who created or what car, but I just want to update the start date and bind it to here. So now I have the 28th of September, and if I go to Supabase, it's currently the 27th for record 6. So now if I test this action, again, it's going to fail. It's saying cannot read properties if undefined. The reason it's failing is because, again, I need to create an RLS policy. So I've allowed people to view their bookings based on their user ID. I've allowed authenticated users to insert, to create a new record. Now I need to allow users to update a record based on their user ID. So I'm gonna again use the delete template that allows users to delete their own records based on their user ID. And instead of delete, I will just say update. And here I will say update. And now if I review this, if I save this and I try again, now the record has been updated, or WeWeb tells me it's been a success. And if I go to Supabase, to my table, my bookings table, I see that now record ID 6 is indeed, has a start date of 28th of September. That's it. That's how you can create and update records in Supabase. The same logic will apply if you need to delete a record. What's important to remember is that you should enable role-level security on your Supabase tables and write the security policies that you need to ensure that only authorized users are accessing the data you want them to access and are able to edit the data you are okay to let them edit.